Using multiple camera cuts, you can showcase any 3D objects at different angles and perspective. In this video, I will talk about a simple method to create this multi-camera setup in Fusion. Here, I used my ribbon 3D effect as an example. In the original setup, on the left, there are nodes for the 3D effector object, including a camera 3D node. On the right, it is the media out node. They're of course connected by a renderer 3D node in the middle. Let's first insert a new merge 3D node before the renderer 3D node. Disconnect the camera 3D node from the old merge 3D node and connect it to the new one. I renamed the new merge 3D node as cam merge because it is the node to connect all cameras at once. Now, copy and paste the camera 3D node to the number of cameras you want. I want to show the effect in three different angles, so I created a total of three cameras. Connect them to the cam merge node. I renamed them as cam 1, cam 2, and cam 3. It's a good practice to rename the nodes, especially if you have duplicated nodes. Next, we need to copy and paste the renderer 3D node to create the same number of renderers as number of cameras. Connect the cam merge node to all of the renderer 3D nodes. Again, don't forget to rename the renderer 3D nodes. We then need to add the same number of merge node as the number of renderers. Remember, they are basic merge nodes, not merge 3D nodes. Connect each renderer to the green triangle of the merge node. And then from top to bottom, connect each merge node to the orange triangle of the next one. Insert a background node and connect it to the orange triangle of the top merge node. In the inspector, decrease the alpha to 0. Finally, connect the bottom merge node to media out. Now, we have all the necessary nodes added and connected. Next, we select each of the renderer nodes, go to inspector, change the camera to the respective camera. Cam 1 for renderer 1, cam 2 for renderer 2, etc. And here comes the most important part, you have to decide when and how long each camera cut is shown. Select a renderer, in the inspector, set the starting and ending frame at the global in-out option. For example, here, I set the global in-out for renderer 1 as 0 to 120, which means the camera 1 cut is shown from the first frame to the 120th frame. Then, I select renderer 2 and set the global in-out as 121 to 240, so that the camera 2 cut will be shown after camera 1. You should plan ahead how long and how many frames for each camera cut, or at which frame you want to switch from one camera to another. I set 120 frames for each cut, which means 2 seconds and 60 frames per second. Make sure global in-out is set for every renderer. Now, the whole setup is basically ready. Next, simply set up camera movements for each camera. Remember, the keyframes should be set within the global in-out frames you just set for the respective camera. For example, I set up the panning movement of camera 1 only from first frame to 120th frame. I select the camera 1, use the arrows in the left viewer, or play around the settings under transform in the inspector to get a desired angle. Then, I go to the first frame and keyframe X value for translation, and then, I go to the 120th frame, which is the last frame for camera 1 cut, and use the red arrow to move the camera to the left. The panning movement is now added to camera 1. Simple. Use the same method to add different movements to every camera. And now you've made a brilliant multi-camera clip. It's time to enjoy the result. If you like this video, give a thumbs up. Subscribe for more effects and tutorials. See you in the next one.